We're talking about minutes yet or anything?
No, not yet.
Not yet.
Okay, hearing none, we will close public comment. Next item, approval of the minutes for the November 8th special meeting.
Once again, my name is spelled wrong.
What?
My name is spelled wrong. Number three, approval of the October 5th regular meeting minutes. My name is Francie.
Well, just like Greg last night was great, it's Francie. At least it's a flattering one.
Fancy, that's fancy, that's not Francie. There's no R in it. F-R-A-N-C-I.
Nice to be fancy.
I'm sorry about that.
This is why first initials are good, right?
Yeah.
And usually I do this for sure.
Yeah.
I don't know, I got carried away, you were being fancy.
Okay, any other additions, deletions, corrections?
To the minutes?
To the minutes, yes, sir.
It has a deal here on what I said last month, which may be kind of reflected in that minutes, but.
Which item?
Item number two, where it says my name.
My question inquired last month is why the fire department didn't show up at the antique peddlers there and take care of the parking problem, which they strictly enforce, the 20-foot parking lanes. They have somebody drive through the barricade, parked in it, called down here and they didn't respond. The tower's been gonna give me an answer since that, whatever it was, middle of October. And apparently he's not here today either.
I don't know why they don't respond, just
I'm gonna keep asking until they tell me.
Howard did say, I've had several conversations with him this month, and he did say that he talked to everybody about that and to the officers who should have been right on that. And that should that happen again, they will be right on it.
The duty officer, whoever was on the phone, advised us that Minetti was on his way down, Jeff, and that they would come down, so.
Yeah, apparently the firefighter, they took their time.
Took their time.
Making sure that somebody was, contacted who had the authority.
You know, if you're gonna ignore it, ignore it, but don't be out here drawing lines and.
Right.
Absolutely. So we'll have the minutes reflect. The question was why the fire department did not respond to the request.
Right.
Any other deletions or corrections? Hearing none, I'd like a motion.
Move to approve.
As amended.
Okay. Moved and seconded to approve the minutes as amended. All in favor? Aye. Opposed? Motion carries. Review of current expenses.
Okay, so the expenses are just a tad bit low on the number we have here, because later in the meeting we will be addressing the acting chief's pay starting back in November, which did not get addressed at the last meeting. So as a result of that, the taxes are not on here. So right now, the current expenses are $20,253.19, and that's going to go up by probably at least $10,000 by the time we add the additional checks and everybody's payroll taxes.
Also, on expenses, we have allocated every month $1,000 for attorney's fees, $6,000 total, and we've already paid the attorney over $17,000 in the last 3 months. Is there some reason why he's making so much money off of us? How much work can there be?
Part of that was the preparation of the documentation for the dissolution. I don't know exactly how much that was, but a significant amount of that was preparation of those documents.
I asked at the last meeting if I could see all the invoices that he sent us, and I still won't have that, and I would like to have that. I'd like to review for the last 3 months what he did to earn $17,000.
So you can come in and give me a copy of the memos as you can.
Okay.
I'd
love to do that.
Any other items? Okay. Hearing none, I will entertain a motion.
You want to make the motion?
I thought you were just going to do it. Or you're just entertaining. Okay, I'll make the motion to accept the budget.
Okay, we have a motion to approve the expenses for the month. A second?
Okay.
All in favor? Aye. Opposed? Motion carries. Update on the dissolution process with LAFCO in the November 16th meeting. Would you like to give a quick update on that, please?
Sure. It was actually a relatively quick meeting, as this was just a status report, info only. It is on LAFCO's website under their special project tab. They were starting with a frequently asked questions draft. This will come before, our issue will come before the Board of Supervisors in early 2018. That's now been stated that will probably be February or March, because the chair of the Board of Supervisors decided that they didn't need to meet weekly, they only needed to meet every other week in the new year. So there will not be meetings every single Tuesday. It will not be every other. And we're looking at level of service, and Supervisor Compton, who sits on LAFCO, was a little bit worried about precedent. And again, these are things that were not discussed. They were just things that were brought up. There will be public hearings. The staff will notice the hearing to landowners. LAFCO will approve, modify, or deny our request. And then send that on to the, approve or modify, we'll go on to the Board of Supervisors, deny, we'll be back working on it with whatever they say the shortcomings were. The protest process is, there's the voters and the landowners, if less than 25% protest, it will automatically be approved. More than that, it will go to a vote of the community. There was some back and forth among, some of the Supervisor Compton again was worried about San Miguel and some others that are actually CSDs and not fire districts in this, because everybody's kind of in the same boat that we are. But there is a big legal difference between a CSD, a community service district, and us. And the community service districts take on this role of responsibilities. They're a pseudo city. They're not quite an incorporated city, but they're like half a step down from it. So, it does make a big difference between something like us and a CSD talking to them. LAFCO member Tom Murray said the timeline would likely to be 3 to 6 months. He's worried about our staffing and the health and safety of our residents, and also is concerned about who else will help us respond to calls. And so he's hoping that CAL FIRE, and Morro Bay can continue to be providing mutual aid on fire calls. Ed Wagge, who I think will be the next chair in January of LAFCO, asked if we could contract with the county or CAL FIRE. Ms. Compton again, asked if CAL FIRE would agree to an increase in the contract, and these are the issues we have kind of discussed in the previous meeting. So Robert Ennis, he says, can the county just say no? And Jeff O'Quest said, well, the county may choose to go either way, but they have an 80-year history for providing fire service in unincorporated areas. So, Mr. Curdy spoke about options. Ms. Friend took Supervisor Compton to task on some of her questions. I spoke on some of the options we were getting on mutual aid and why they did or did not work on the long term for us.
So this will all be reflected in their minutes?
Oh, yeah.
Correct.
Mr. Murray wants information on other county funding that would be available. Mr. Enns talked about, if CCAC was involved or not, and to clarify the LAFCO versus Board of Supervisors role. And Chair Marshall, or Marshall Wachilski said, this may or may not.
Well, won't this be reflected in your minutes too? Because not everybody's going to go look at theirs.
Yes, ma'am.
What your report of?
Yeah.
Cool.
Yeah, that's why we're going through it. So that was the end of my notes because they moved on to the next item.
So that's where it sits. It's in the process moving forward. We're waiting now on the Board of Supervisors. As soon as we can get it on their agenda for them to take recommendations from staff, their staff is currently putting together options and costs and their position.
Have you presented to LAFCO, I know you put forward the level of service that you requested. Have you also now had a chance to put forward to them the estimated cost of that service?
Yes, you're talking about the options?
Well,
they had requested background on the options that were discussed, and so I have forwarded that information to you.
So on all those options that the advisory committee presented to you?
Correct.
Okay.
They asked for that, we have submitted that to you.
Okay.
Question.
Has there been any pursuit of the idea that if there's a countywide increase in a 218 vote to increase fire costs countywide, that we would be exempt from the first $105 or something because we already taxed that much?
I don't believe we've gotten to that point because the there currently is no no move or no discussion of increasing the county fire tax or creating a county fire tax countywide. So we have not brought that up, because the subject hasn't come up.
Okay.
But trust that if it does, we will pursue that.
Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
If the county refuses to cover us, what do we do with our tax dollars that go to them?
Back. Yeah, the I'm not sure.
Didn't you say that they might say no to covering?
If they don't provide don't want to provide the level of service that's adequate for Cayucas, that C-12 will still be on the books. We're back at square one to figure out what to do with this department. Okay. Any other questions, comments? Okay, hearing none, we will move on to the next item, review and discuss the 2018 office space lease agreement for the two water agencies. I missed one. Discuss and approve asking the Cayuga Citizens Advisory Council to assist in gathering public opinion regarding the fire district.
It's not mine.
I think it's a good idea. Because our meetings are during the day when a lot of people are working. The advisory council meetings are in the evening, so more people can attend and get the information that they need. It's not always possible for them to come to our meetings to get the information.
Right. We have maintained all along that we will be holding evening public town hall meetings to discuss where we're at and the options that are before us. The reason we haven't had those before is there's no options before us to be able to look at.
Right.
So when we have that information, then we will call a town hall meeting and have the community able to attend.
I think that's a better idea than involving another group of... for a year and a half, I heard what we should do and what we should do this, we should do that. But I've never heard one iota where any money's coming from. mean, all these are great things, and everybody wishes we could go back to 5 years ago, but nobody, including the fire department, has come up with any money suggestions other than being helped out by the county.
Exactly. Until we know what the options are out there and what they're going to cost and who's going to pay for it.
Well,
I think it's premature to gnaw the bone continuously.
I agree.
We have no new information. Nothing has changed from where we are currently. Yes, ma'am.
I think the town meetings are a better idea than the CCAC because you already have a board. If you were if the fire department didn't have a governing board, then I can see where you would need to go to the CCAC. But what you all did the last time, where you sent out the postcards to the community and everybody knew what was going on and knew what was that they should be there if they were interested, I think that was an excellent way to do it.
Thank you. Further discussion? Hearing none. Now we'll review and discuss the office space agreement.
Pretty straightforward, $300. The reason this has come up is because the lease actually expires at the end of this month. This has been a lease situation, and the question becomes, in order to renew it, should we make this a month-to-month agreement? Otherwise, we're going to have to, if we make it a lease, we're going to have to add a clause in here that says, you know, at the point of dissolution, it will be the county that decides whether they get to stay or not. I mean, because at that point, we don't, you know, the lease would, I think, technically be null and void there because it wouldn't be this entity. But I think to make everybody really clear on this, it's $600 a month income. I'm all for I'm all for income. But I think that moving this to a month-to-month instead of an annual lease would be put everybody in a much better situation. And that way, you know, if they find something, if they see dissolution is going, looks like it's going forward and it's going to happen, they start looking, they find a place, not an issue getting out. I don't think we would have an issue in letting them out, but it still makes it just much cleaner, I think, for everybody.
Are they in agreement with that?
We asked them if they needed to be here. So
we haven't discussed month to month with them. This is the first time this has come up.
I just texted Grace. She's on the phone, so she was trying to listen to this.
Mm-hmm.
But she's on the phone, so she can't. She's working.
Okay. Yeah, I talked to Jordan Brennan, and he's the president of Warren Rock, and he said, just pass on to the board that, you know, we're willing to stay as long as we can.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it's, you can change it to month to month and then present it to them, or, you know, I don't know what kind of notice you have to.
Well, their lease expires at the end of this month, so they're basically without a lease.
I know.
That's okay. It took 5 months last year.
the
lease turns
typically
into a month.
Typically, with
a
lease, if it has not been negotiated, the existing lease stands in force.
Is that number 13?
Yes.
Why not just
the whole one?
It changes to a month, on that. At least, mm-hmm. If not,
because yeah, it's not renamed as existing lease, supposed to live. So then you guys could just do nothing.
But it's better to have a legal agreement in place.
Well, that and to let them know, they need to know where we're at. I've had some discussions with one of their board members as well. So they are aware of where we're at and what's going on.
Is there a change in the term over their payment on this? So you could consider just leaving your lease in place, allowing it to go into holdover position, which is month to month, solves your problem, I believe.
You maybe just write the board, write them a letter saying that you're going to stick with number 13 month to month.
We will do that. I will work with you to do that if the board concurs.
Sure.
Okay, the acting chief's report. Howard couldn't make it today. He's out on his day job. Cheryl, you said you discussed this with him?
Discussed this with him. So in terms of equipment, the chief's vehicle was smogged a couple days ago. At some point, the Cambria grant was we did not get that. That was the one for the turnout and stuff. So Howard's going to put together a list of items that would have been covered under that and the cost. There's some plumbing issues with the shower that had to be addressed because of the, as we all know in Cayucas, the ancient plumbing in all of these buildings. It was a loud noise and vibrations, and he assured me there was nobody singing in the shower. Let's see, last month there were 23 calls for service in the month of November, so it was a relatively light month. 8 medical, 8 PSAs, 3 false alarms, 4 hazardous conditions, and 362 calls for the year so far. In terms of personnel, Matthew Tobes completed his driver operator, so we have one more. And Howard has offered him a resident reserve captain position. It's all about what the abbreviations mean in your mind. Stephen Yoder was offered an officer position also as soon as he's released from his knee injury. So he's supposed to get released next Tuesday. Depends. Hostin Morrison is back and was offered a reserve captain position. However, he was called back to Cal Fire.
Keith and
Inferno. We've got a new fire in Malibu today, new fire at Buellton that closed Highway 101 today. Today. Yes.
It's not over.
It's not over.
The toes are captain is good.
Paid call firefighter Logan Wilcutt has resigned.
Isn't he the one that just...
Yeah, he just came back and then he decided he didn't want to go.
So, current staffing is 1 acting chief, 4 captains, 2 reserve captains, 6 paid call firefighters, 4 reserve driver operators, 7 reserve firefighters. All officers are also drivers for a total of 11. The December schedule has a duty officer for every shift, and firefighter shifts are all full except December 25th, where at this point there's only 1 firefighter. Howard is hoping to have that filled, or it gets to be
mandatory.
New work. And so 9 shifts currently don't have a driver schedule. However, one of the officers on call or on duty is a driver. We have 2 applications for new reserves. Part of them is Cal Fire still got them on duty. Mm-hmm. And as long as we're burning Southern California, this week they're staffing with an additional firefighter or driver for the week due to the weather and wind events, so that if something happens in town, we've already got at least 1 additional already here in the building. Let's see, we already talked about the Cambria grant. We did 2 fire plan reviews, 3 project referrals, no final inspections. Just an update on the Dolphin Inn. The Dolphin Inn did end up being closed for a period by county code enforcement for numerous violations. It has been allowed to reopen. Most of the deficiencies have been repaired that were included wall heaters, GFI plugs and bathrooms, faulty electrical, exposed wiring, and flammable storage, just to name a few. The owner apparently is looking to demolish and build anew as soon as possible, that plans and permits could be put together. So the county decided to go ahead with the repairs and let them open. Fire department delivered Santa and Mrs. Claus to the Christmas tree on December 3rd. The Christmas open house there, is on December 9th, 5 to 8. And the Chamber of Commerce Polar Bear Dip is at noon on New Year's Day for you brave souls.
Okay, so we will receive the chief's report. Review and discuss correspondence. I have received none. Lori?
I haven't received any. Okay.
Old business, review of the district website progress.
What's going on?
That's what we're going to find out.
Well, we've been trying to, Rocky had said it would take 8 hours, and so we've been desperately trying to get to her. So she finally emailed me back, and we've got a few things we need to provide her some verbiage on. The board, there's a section by each board member that says, read more if you would like a little bit more information about yourself on the website underneath your name as a board member. If you could email that to Lori. You know, however much or little you would like to have on there, we're going to leave that up to each board member. Then a couple of questions that I noted is, it wasn't really obvious where we were posting meeting docs and the historical docs at this point, so I'll be contacting her back with clarification on that. And there was no place yet that we had asked for a place to put events or community notices. So if it's you know, time change, time to check your batteries and change your batteries. We wanted a place for those kind of things in the front page. If there was just, you know, a major community event that's going to close down streets, if we know about it in advance, you know, we wanted to be able to put those kind of things on, and there is no space yet. But this is the first chance that I had this morning to be able to look.
So, I mean, she has no space on the page that she's creating, or what do you mean?
Is it created yet?
It's not up and published yet.
Oh, okay.
It was just her first draft based on the meeting that Lori and I had with her to go over the requirements. So we'll get back to her with those, and she'll do another draft. And then when all of that's ready, we can circulate it for final board comment before we make it go active.
Is there a timeline on completion?
It'd be nice if we got it done before January, so we could start with January's minutes on there.
Yeah, it would be really nice.
January.
I'm gonna make that. We thought it was gonna be
8 hours.
8 hours. Maybe a week.
10 minutes. Of time.
It took a couple weeks to get a response. So.
Okay.
So, but it is going.
All right. Thank you. Item 10, review and discuss possible and possibly approve change to the acting chief's salary. In our offer of title change and responsibility change to Howard Sanford going from the assistant chief to the acting chief, the board has discussed and would continue to discuss increasing his salary from the current $1,750 a month to $2,500 a month. I must say that in the month that Howard has had the position as acting chief, he's jumped in with both feet and is making a lot of, putting in a lot of time, making a lot of improvements to the department, its operations, and in my mind is doing a yeoman's job in that regard.
Chief Manetti out?
Chief Manetti did retire. He did offer to come back for a period of time in the capacity as a driver to drive the engine until we could get some of these folks through training, which Howard was able to do, and also attract some other talent to fill in as drivers, so we don't have near the issue that we had in the month of October where we didn't have sufficient driver operators.
I think it's reasonable to pay him at least that, since we were going to pay the acting chief that turned down the job twice that amount. And Howard's very familiar with the department and has been there a long time, so I don't think there should be a problem I mean, I personally think you should be getting paid more than $2,500, but that's just me.
Well, but also we didn't, because of his full-time employment, we also didn't increase the number of mandated shifts that he had to work.
Yeah, but the guy that we originally hired wasn't going to work any shifts. He was just going to work 20 hours a week. He wasn't pulling any shifts. So,
well, he was going to be here 5 days a week.
You know, he was only going to be here 4 days a week.
Four days. But he was going to
20 hours, 4 days a week, no shifts. So Howard's doing all that.
Well, I think what we talked about before was $2,500 a month and maintaining it at two shifts per week. And then he still gets paid, if he does additional shifts, gets paid the $75, which is standard for additional shifts, with maybe a review in February to see where that's at.
We're still at the department.
We're not going to the board.
We'll still be here in February.
I move $2,500 per month, two shifts per week.
I have a motion.
You in February.
I have a motion.
I guess I have to second that motion.
No, you don't have to.
No. Right. Steve's good. I'll second.
Motion made and seconded to increase the acting chief salary from $1,750 a month to $2,500 a month with a review in February. All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? Motion carries.
I think
she's
I'm sorry.
Did you vote no or yes?
What
does
she do? It's 30. Yes. Her
did you vote yes or no?
I
don't
know. Because I think you should get paid more.
But she made the second.
Okay.
So you
well,
made
I didn't have a choice.
She could vote her against her own second. It's
it doesn't matter if it's second or not because they're going to vote.
Purpose of a motion is to just want to have a discussion on the floor.
Yeah. That's the purpose of a motion is to open the subject for discussion. Mm-hmm. That's all.
Okay. The
motions are supposed to be positive, not negative.
So two yeses and one no.
Two yeses, one no. Last item on the agenda, items for the next agenda. The next meeting will be on, as I get my calendar up here, Thursday, January 4th.
I would like to have the realignment, mid-year realignment of the budget.
Anything else?
That could take us a while.
That will be a spirited discussion, I'm sure. Okay, hearing nothing else, we will adjourn the meeting.
Wow.
For all of you who hate legal size paper, the agenda will not be legal size paper.